Hello Internet, so nice to see you! Today we see what is the exact difference between the time signature 3-4 and the time signature 6-8 and how we can leverage this difference in interesting ways to make our music better. Now there is some confusion between 3-4 and 6-8 because if we interpret the time signature as a fraction, 3-4 is equal to 6-8, equal to 0.75. So again, from a mathematical point of view, those two time signatures look really similar. But here's the point. The time signature indication is not a fraction. This is not what the time signature indicates. The time signature indicates a natural pattern of accent that then you can override when you write your music. So while 3-4 and 6-8 both indicate a bar length that can fit either 6-8 notes or 3/4 notes, they are not the same at all. Let's start with 3-4. 3-4 indicates 3 beats in your bar, which means a cycle of 3 beats in which the main accent is put on the first beat. This is the standard time signature, for instance, for dances like waltz, in which you have a rhythm pattern like zoom-pa-pa, zoom-pa-pa, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, with the accent on 1. On the other hand, 6-8 does not indicate 6 beats, it indicates 2 beats that are to be divided in 3, that is 1 and a, 2 and a. 6-8, if you want, is an alternative way of writing a bar of 2-4 using triplets. So the accent on a 6-8 bar are naturally on the first 8 note and on the 4th 8 note. And again, they create a rhythm of 1 and a, 2 and a. So far we have just seen, though, that there are two different patterns of accent, grouping the beats in 2, 1-2-1-2-1-2, which is the 3-4, and grouping the beats in 3, 1-2-3-1-2-3, which is the 6-8. And we have seen that those are written differently in music notation. But even if these are two different things, and they are even notated differently, musicians of all styles have leverage on the fact that those two bars have the same length. So it's common to use those two accent patterns together. Using those two accent patterns together, it's sometimes called hemiola. These come from the Greek hemi, one half, and holos, a whole, and so it means one and a half. Because hemiola is leveraging on the contrast it will have with the rhythm in 3 and the rhythm in 2, and 3 divided by 2 is 1/2. Yeah, I know this is not a great explanation of the origin of the name, but hey, I didn't name it, I'm just telling you how it is. Now, there are two ways to put together those rhythm patterns. The first way to put together the pattern of 3-4 and the pattern of 6-8 is called the successive or horizontal hemiola. When we use the pattern of 3 plus 3 and the pattern of 2 plus 2 plus 2, one after the other. We can use them in any order. So I can put the 3 plus 3 before and the 2 plus 2 plus 2 after, or I can put them in the opposite way. So if I put the 3 first, this sounds like 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. If I put the 2s before the 3s, it sounds like 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now the super famous example, the one that everybody quotes, the one that everybody remembers, is the super famous song America from the musical West Side Story.
I like to be in America, okay by me in America, everything free in America,
for a small fee in America.
You can clearly hear the 3 plus 3 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 pattern in the melody of the chorus. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Incidentally, I also personally love this song because of this line that I dedicate to everybody who's ever commented on the way I speak.
Better get rid of your accent.
But of course, America is not the only possible example of this. There are many other, so here we see a different example from a completely different style of music. This is the second movement of Ravel's string quartet in F major, and you can hear the pattern of 3 plus 3 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 in the pizzicato violin that gives a nice rhythmic feeling to the whole thing. By the way, the whole string quartet in F major, it's a great piece of music. I do recommend you find the time to listen to the whole of it. It's just great. Now we can stay here and see many, many, many more examples of this, but I want to go ahead on the second ways of using the rhythm of 3 plus 3 and the rhythm of 2 plus 2 plus 2 together. That is the simultaneous or vertical hemiola. When you play them at the same time, not one after another, but together at the same time. So as it happens, you're going to have this situation. You're going to have one bar with 6 time units inside that you can notate as 3, 4 or 6, 8, however you prefer. And we're going to put in both the accent of the 3 plus 3, so here and here, and the accent of the 2 plus 2 plus 2, so here, here and here. And then we're going to play them at the same time. Now, this is not particularly hard to do. Of course, the thing will sound different if this bar is notated 3-4 or if this bar is notated 6-8 because you are hearing it on the background of 2 beats or 3 beats. So if the bar is notated 3-4, my underlying rhythm is 1-2-3, 1-2-3, and this rhythm sounds this way. 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3. On the other hand, if the bar is notated 6-8, I have the background of 2 beats divided in 3 each. This is the standard notation for our rhythm pattern, and it sounds this way. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Now, this rhythm, as it is, it's very common, and it's heard in a lot of songs. But if I can put my opinion in there, I don't think this rhythm is particularly groovy because it puts too much emphasis on the downbeat. So here's a little trick to take a boring rhythm and make it a bit more exciting. We just displace the rhythm. We just move the whole rhythm one time unit later in the bar. So now, if our bar is notated 3-4, so we are on a background of 3 beats, then our rhythm will sound this way. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. If our bar instead is notated 6-8, again I have 2 beats divided in 3, this is a standard notation for it, and that's how it sounds. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. This kind of rhythm feels to me much more interesting and groovy than the original one. So hey, it's just a little trick, and maybe you can use it to create some good music. Regardless though, if you use 3-4 or 6-8, or you use both feelings and accent pattern as we have seen, once you have the rhythm down, you need just to get your harmony under control and put in the right chords over those rhythms. So for this, I do recommend you check out my course Complete Chord Mastery, which is not a book and not even a series of books. It's a complete video course that talks about chord progression and everything there is to know about harmony on guitar. The course is made specifically for guitar players. We do all our harmony straight on the fretboard. We don't use pianos. We just do everything on the fretboard, so it's super intuitive and super useful for a guitar player. And if you have a minute, just click on the link and check it out. If you like this video, smash on that like button and don't forget to subscribe and click on notification, otherwise YouTube will not tell you when I put up a new video. And if you have any suggestions for new videos or comments or any kind of feedback, please write it down in the comments. I enjoy reading your comments. This is Tommaso Zilia of MissBeautyForGuitar.com, and until next time, enjoy!